alaikum. Today our topic is balance sheet. This is chapter number 8 of your book. And now we will study a detailed description about the balance sheet. Now, what is balance sheet? Why it is required in the offices, in the institutions, in any working organization? What is the urge of balance sheet? Where it is necessary in the accounts department and why it is useful. Let's see about the balance sheet. Balance sheet is basically, is a detailed statement about all your assets, all your liabilities, all your capital occurred during a specified period of time, occurred within a period of time, that is from 2019 till 2020. Let's suppose. Till one year time period. Its time period is at the end of every year, you have to make a proper balance sheet. Within a year, within a specified period of time. It's up to you, it's up to the organizations that they are making the balance sheet. It may be if they are required after the 6 months, or it may be required after 1 year. So these are the different forms of balance sheets. Many organizations may want it at the end of the year, especially in the banks, talking about the banks, the financial institutions, the microfinance banks, talking about the schools, or talking about the multinational companies. They may want it after 6 months, after 3 months, after 2 months. So every organization, every institution have different patterns, but this maintenance or the pattern of the balance sheet is same. It is not changed in any other organization. As I told you, that balance sheet consists of a list of assets, liabilities and capitals. Balance sheet has two parts like this, assets and liabilities. This is a pattern. Here you put assets and liabilities and the owner's equity. These both sides must be equal. It is necessary, they are both sides of the balance sheet must be equal. Let's consider the components of the balance sheet. Talking about the assets, when we talk about the assets, we all know what are assets. We have studied in chapter number 1. At the starting of the chapter, we have studied assets are basically defined as the owner's cash amount, owner's on hand, equipment, any kind of equipment, any kind of long-term assets, any kind of long-term cash. That it is included in the assets. Assets further categorize into two parts, front assets and fixed assets. We all know what are front assets. We have studied in chapter number 1. Front assets is defined as assets which are used within a 1 year, within a period of time. And fixed assets are those assets which are for long term. That may be more than 5 years, more than 10 years. Examples of fixed assets are, buildings, land, machinery, fixtures and fittings. We have studied these examples in chapter number 1. Talking about the examples of front assets, examples are, we have stocks, we have cash in hand, cash in bank, we have debtors. Now, the second component is liabilities. We all know liabilities which we have to pay. Anything which we have to pay is your liability. Liabilities, obviously any business, any organization will inquire about the liabilities. Any business cannot run about the liability. Again, we have two components in liabilities divided into two parts, front liabilities and long-term liabilities. Front liabilities, again, we have to due it, we have to pay it within a period of time, that may be 1 year, 2 years, not more than that. Long-term liabilities, again, they have long-term durable, that may be more than 5 years, you can pay it after 5 years, you can pay it after 10 years. Talking about the capital, we have the capital. In the capital is the basically defined as the cash which the owner has introduced it in the business. It's the introduction of it's the owner's cash. In capital we have two more titles, that is the drawings and the net profit. Drawings is the owner's amount which he or she is using for his personal use, and net profit, we all know, whatever the profit we are gaining from the business or the organization.